The following is a class on the Srimad Bhagavatam, 1st Canto, 2nd Chapter, Text Number 14, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on August 17, 1972, in Los Angeles.
Translation: Therefore, devotees should constantly hear about, glorify, remember, and worship the Personality of Godhead, Bhagavan, who is their protector.
Tasmat, therefore, it is continuation of the last verse. What was the last verse? Atapungvidhijasreshtabarnasamabhibhagas sanusthitasadharmasasangsiddhiharitosa. Everyone should know how to become perfect. That education is not there. They do not know what is perfection. They do not know that I am eternal. My struggle for existence is for perfection of life. To come to my original position, Krishna consciousness, so that I may regain again my eternal blissful life of knowledge. That is the aim. So it is required, therefore, that the social system should be organized in such a way that automatically people become interested into the ultimate goal of life. That is civilization. This is not civilization, simply animal propensities. Eat voraciously and sleep 20 hours and have sex life without any restriction and have atom bomb for defense. That's all. Finish. Civilization. Ahara nidra bhaya maithunancha samanna meitatva. These things are there in the animals. That's like goats. You have seen goats eating 24 hours. Not only goats, all other animals. Even if a strong animal, that they are, I told you, nahi suptasya singasya prabhishanti mukhe miga. Suptasya, sleeping, lion. Lion is very powerful. He is given the honor of becoming the king of the animals. But still, he has to work for eating. It is not that because he is lion, he will be sleeping and some animal will come and enter into his mouth. No. That is not possible. He has to work. Similarly, everyone has to work. Therefore, there must be systematic work, so that whole society may develop Krishna consciousness, the ideal or the goal of life. Without program working, just like I was hearing that in Japan, they are very much, the people are very much liking for working, but they, by law they are being prohibited, don't work. So this civilization has been created that they do not know anything more. They are not taught that working is not our main business. Our main business is, as it is stated, haritosanam, sangsiddhi haritosanam. We have to satisfy Krishna, the Supreme Personality of God, or God, whatever you say. But they do not know what is God. So, there is no God, there is no life. These things are being taught throughout the whole world. The Charvak theory. Charvak theory is that Rinam Kritya Kritam Pived Javad Jive Sukham Jive and Bhashi Bhutasya Dehasya Kuto Punaragamana Bhaved. Bhashi Bhutasya Dehasya. In India, according to Vedic system, the body is burnt after death. They are not so foolish to stalk and occupy millions and square years. No, his body is finished, just burn it, finished. Why stalk it in a tomb and occupy so much space? Practical, you see. So, bhasibhutasya dehasya. Bhasibhutasya means the body being burnt, it becomes ashes. So, actually, the ultimate form or format of this body are three. Either you become stool, or you become ash, or you become earth. Those who are burying underground, after a few years the body will become earth. And those who are throwing on the street or on the water, so that body will become stool, because if you throw on land, some jackals and some animals, some vultures, they will come and eat, and by after eating, it will be stool. So, either ashes or stool or earth, this is the last stage of this body. And we are taking of this stool, ash and earth so much without caring for the real vital force which is moving the body. We are very much careful for ash, stool and earth. Not careful of the living force which is moving this body, beautiful body. This body is beautiful, very attractive, very important. So long the spiritual spark is there. Otherwise it is stool, ash and earth. They do not know this. So this requires intelligence. That intelligence is divided into these varnasam dharma. There must be intelligent class of men, Brahman. They are called intelligent class of men. Chaturbanna maya system. The society must be divided into four classes for cooperation. I have explained yesterday. So at the present moment, two classes are wanting. The Brahman class and the Kshatriya class. The Vaishya class and the Shudra class and less than Shudra class are there. Because in the Kali Yuga it is stated, Kalo Shudra Sambhava. Kalo, in this age, most major portion of the population will be Shudras. Shudras means fourth class men. Fourth class men means Shuddha karma sabhavajam. What is that? Paricharjyatmakam karmam. It's like dog. A dog, unless it has got a nice master, it is street dog. It has no value. Anyone can kill. And it has no shelter, loitering in the street. So Shudra means dog's position. If he does not get a nice master, then street dog. In spite of high education, MA, PhD, DSc and this and that, if he does not get an employment, he's street dog. What is his value? Oh, I have studied high technical education. But if you do not get a service for using your education, then you are a street dog. Is it not? Everyone is searching after some service. So this service attitude means Sudra. Paricharyatmakam karjam Sudra karma svabhavajam. In the Shastras, therefore, it is said that the Brahmins, if there is some difficult time, just like nowadays, at the present moment, we are creating Brahmanas, but people do not much like us. They do not care for them. What is this? Krishna consciousness, chanting Hare Krishna, their street. They are thinking that beggars. But they are the most intelligent class, Brahmanas, they do not honor. But this Kali Yuga, actual intelligent class of man has no honor. A third class man, fourth class man, fifth class man has got honor. If he gets some money. That is the system of Kali Yuga. Somehow or other, you gather money and you are fifth class, tenth class man, you will be honored. This is Kali Yuga. Not for your qualification, but because you have got money, you are honored. This is Kali Yuga. So Kalau Sudra Sambhava, at the present moment, 99.9, they are Sudras. Therefore, the society is chaotic condition. Therefore, in your country, you are the richest country in the world, you are producing hippies, frustration, confusion, chaotic condition. And if you continue this, then you lose all your opportunities. Artificially, you cannot remain opulent for many days. There are so many empires, Roman Empire, British Empire, Mughal Empire. This was artificial. If you systematically follow the Vedic principles as it is ordered by Krishna, chatut bannang maya system gunakarma vibhagasa, you must divide the society according to quality and work. Four classes of man: Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Sudra. And less than Sudra, they are neglected. Not neglected, they are incorrigible. But Krishna consciousness is so nice, even those who are incorrigible, they can be devoted. That is mentioned in the Srimad Bhagavatam. Kirata hunanda pulinda pukkasa abhira sumbha javana kasada janne cha papa jadupasaya sram Suddhanti Prabhavishnavi Namaha. This movement is so strong that even the fifth class, sixth class, after Sudra, then fifth class, sixth class, gone, unlimited. Only the upper four classes are counted to be really civilized organization. Otherwise, there are so many divisions of it. So, but if the upper four classes are in right order, the same example can be, if your upper portion of the body, the head and the hands, you can protect, you can fight. Then if the upper portion is cut off, your head is cut off, your hands are cut off, then no more fighting. You fall down. Is it not? So they do not know this science. They are killing the upper portion, the Brahman class, the Kshatriya class. Formerly, the Kshatriya class, they are being trained. Just like I am now writing notes on Bhagavatam, the four princes, they are to be given in charge of the kingdom. Before giving charge, they are sent for austerity. And they met Lord Shiva. And Lord Shiva gave them instruction. And for 10,000 of years, within water standing, they underwent austerity. Then they came back and took charge of the kingdom. This is Kshatriya. Just like Dhruva Maharaj. Dhruva Maharaj, at the age of 5 years old, he left his father's home, went to the forest, and with determination he saw God, Krishna, within 6 months. But after coming back, when he was older, when he became king, he was so powerful that there was some mischief done by the sons of Kuvera. He killed them like anything. He killed them anything so that the Kubera personally requested that, Maharaj Dhruva, I know that they are in criminals, you are doing your duty as king, but I request, otherwise my whole dynasty will be finished. So immediately Dhruva Maharaj accepted a great man's request, Kubera. And this Kubera, being so satisfied by the behavior of Dhruva Maharaj, that he was prepared to give him any benediction. My dear king, you can ask me from any benediction you like. You have kept my request. What Dhruva Maharaj asked him, he was Kubera. Kubera means the treasurer of the demigods. If he wanted that the whole treasury of the universe should be given to me, he would have given it. But what he asked, my dear sir, you are so kind, you are prepared to give me all benediction. Please give me this benediction so that I may be attached to the lotus feet of Krishna. This is Kshatriya. If required, they'll fight and finish the whole opposite party. Otherwise, the devotees. That's Arjuna. Arjuna, a Kshatriya. Not that Arjuna was coward. He was sympathetic. Krishna, what is the use of this fighting? The other party, all my relatives, if I kill them, then what do I gain? Actually, that is the fact. We work so hard, accumulate money for showing to our relatives, to our friends, that just see how I become rich. But if they are all gone, then whom shall I show this kingdom? Thinking like ordinary worldly man. But he was not a coward. Not that he was hesitating to fight. But when he understood that Krishna wants this fighting, oh, that's all right. Then Krishna asked him, my dear Arjuna, what is your decision? Yes, karishye vachanandam. Yes, I shall fight. This is Krishna consciousness. Krishna wants this fighting. I do not want. Oh, I have nothing to what is my value? Krishna wants it, that is value. This is Kshatriya. They finished the whole grandfather and grandchildren and everything. Finished. The other party, Kauravas. Not a single person lived. This is Kshatriya. And Brahmana giving direction. All the Kshatriya's kings were taking direction from highly learned sages and Vyasa, Yudhishthira Maharaj. So these two classes are now wanted. Here is stated. Chaturvan, Varnasrama, Varnasrama Vibhavas. Otherwise this present human civilization is dead. There must be these two classes of men, Brahmana and Kshatriya. Shudras and Vaishyas are there. There are so many shopkeepers and workers and laborers. There is sufficient number. Now there is no Brahmana and Kshatriya. So our Krishna consciousness movement is to give give some benediction to the whole human society. It is not a sectarian so-called religion, sentiment. No. It is a scientific movement. Scientific movement, if you say why you are interested to save the human society, that is Krishna's business. Krishna wants, God wants, that all these living entities, they should come back home, back to Godhead. Why they are suffering? Therefore Krishna comes personally. Paritranaya sadhunam vinasaya cha duskritam dharma samasthapanarthaya sambhavami yugi yugi. Krishna is very anxious. We are suffering here, rotting here. We are sons of Krishna. Krishna does not like to see that we shall rot here. He wants, come back, home. Dance with me, eat with me. But these rascals will not go. They will stick here. No, sir, it is very good here. I shall become hog and eat stool. That is very pleasant. And this is position. Therefore, because we are Krishna conscious, we are servants of God. Therefore, it is our duty to save this human civilization. But Krishna wants it. And to save this human civilization, these two classes are required very urgently. So, you, American boys and girls, you are intelligent, you have got all facilities. At least in your country, create these two classes, Brahman and Kshatriya. The world will be saved, and you will be saved, and Krishna will be pleased. Brahmana's business means that people should know what is God, what is our relationship with Him. That is Brahmana. And Kshatriya's business is to give protection to the people so that they may all know what is God. That is Kshatriya. And Vaishya's business is to provide food for them, production. And Shudra's is to help all these three classes by their labor. This is social organization. It is not that everyone will become Brahmin or everyone will become Kshatriya. No. At the present moment, the communists are trying, everyone should be communist. And that is not possible. You cannot make everyone of the same class. No, that is not possible. You have to use your intelligence in such a way that these four divisions can work cooperatively and become perfect. And that is suggested here. Sanushtitasya dharmasya saṃsiddhi haritosanam. That common platform is how to please Krishna. Never mind, you are Brahman, you are Kshatriya, you are Vaishya. But so long we are in the material world, there must be four divisions. And the Kshatriya should give protection. Otherwise the demons will disturb. So there is the necessity of war with the demons. But Kshatriya. So these three classes are required, Brahman, Kshatri, to give protection. And as soon as the social system is organized, the perfectional point is to satisfy Krishna or the Supreme Lord. Therefore in the next verse it is a tasmāt bhārata tasmādekena manasā bhagavān sātatāṅapati. Sutabhyo. How you can satisfy God if you do not know God? If you manufacture God? Sutabhyo. Hear about God. What is God? Don't become nonsense, accept a rascal, a God. There is meaning of God. What is God? Not a dog, a God. Sutabhyo. Sutabhyo. And keep the basa and spread that knowledge. It's like you are hearing about God. Now you have to spread it. Keep the basa. Not that, oh, I am not God. That's all I. Let me satisfy. No. You must preach. That is another business. Because people are ignorant. They do not know what is God. That manufacturing God, that accepting some rascal as God. So, what is real God? You must preach. Sotabha kirtitabhascha dheya. And you should always think of God. Then you will get intelligence. If you think of something else for sense gratification, then it will not be done. Formally, simply a soap that I have devoured. No. They are always thinking of God. Always thinking of Krishna. They are pujyascha and offering worship, just like we have got this in the temple. Chanting Hare Krishna, that is there, and pujyascha and offering worship to the Lord. So preaching, hearing, always thinking of and worshiping. These four things are required. Then everything will go all right. It is not official business. After 1 week you go and God give us our daily bread and go home. No. Nitada, 24 hours you should be business, engaged in this business. Nitada. What is the meaning of nitada? Constant. Kirtaniya sadahari. That is it. Life should be molded in such a way that not for a single moment you are without Krishna consciousness. That is real life. That is perfection. Because you have to make your life perfect by satisfying Krishna, satisfying God. Saṃsiddhi haritosanam. If you want perfection, Nibhakti, if you want again to become cats and dogs, which have already passed through and now you have come to this human form of body, then you do whatever you like. But if you want to make this life perfect, stop this business of becoming repeatedly cats and dogs and trees and this and that. Then this is the process. The small Bharata. Ekena manasa. Concentrating fully. Ekena. With one attention, no diverse. Ekena manasa bhagavan saptang pati. Don't be afraid that if I simply concentrate my mind in Krishna, then how other things will go on. No. Bhagavan saptang pati. He is very careful about his devotee. Krishna, God is giving everyone's food. But that is according to karma, according to his quality and position. He is getting food, just like hog is getting food, but he cannot get more than stool. He cannot claim, give me halwa. No, that's not possible. You must eat stool. Because you have, by your karma you have got this body, hog. You must eat stool. So those who are under the karma, under the principles of nature's law, that is karma, nature's law, they are different. Prakite kriyamanani gunai karmani sarvasa ahankara vimunatma. Those who are ordinary living entities, they are being carried away by pull, they are being pulled by the ear, by nature's law. But those who are devotees, that position is different. They are under the special attention of the Supreme Personality of God. He therefore declares, Kuntiya pratijanihi name bhakta pranasati. My dear Arjuna, you can declare to the world that anyone who is my pure devotee, he will never be vanquished. I shall take care. Why he is asking Arjuna to declare? Because a devotee's attempt is never baffled. That is Krishna's desire. Even his own declaration may be sometimes false. But if a devotee declares, Krishna will see, it must be done. It must be done. Just like Hiranya Kashipu. He was given benediction by devotee, Lord Brahma. He tactfully got so many benedictions. I shall not die in this way, I shall not die in this way. But Krishna saw that this rascal has created some complication. How to kill him? So keep the words of the devotee, Lord Brahma. He did not touch all the conditions proposed by Hiranyakashipu. He did something else and killed him. He wanted that I shall not be killed by man, by animal, or lion. Nrisimhadev is neither man nor animal. He wanted I shall not be killed in daytime or night or light. He was killed in the evening, which is neither day nor night. He wanted that I shall not be killed on land, on water, on air, or light. He was killed on the lap. This is God. But you may be very intelligent to trick with God, but God is still more intelligent to, cut down all your tricks, and He must put you into death. Mrityu sarva harasraham. That you cannot avoid. If you say there is no God, God will come at the time of your death, just like Hiranyakashipu. He did not believe in God, but God came. Yes, here is God. You see now. What is God? So before meeting God in that way, the best thing is to see God always within the heart. Premanjana charita bhakti vilochanena santas sadaiva hridayesu bilabhayanti. Those who have got developed God consciousness, he is always seeing God within heart. That should be practiced. Thank you.